lot happened during the first week of preseason games, but only a little bit of it matters. Like Rashad White being rested with Tampa Bay's starters. Mike Evans and Chris Godwin were the only other skill position players to rest for Tampa Bay, while Keyshawn Vaughn and Chase Edmonds combined for 34 snaps. That tells us that Rashad White's 8th round ADP is actually a value, since the team could view him as a 3-down back. Zay Jones is another winner from this week, given his role with the Jaguars offense. Jones actually played in 2 wide sets across from Calvin Ridley. Kirk's only snap from out wide was actually a run blocking play in his direction. So we think Zay Jones will be starting across from Calvin Ridley, not Christian Kirk. Both can get there. But remember, Jones averaged a 25% target share to Kirk's 22.7% from week 11 on, with 4 top 8 finishes. And if he's going to be on the field permanently in 2 wide sets, he's being undervalued. Deshaun Watson only got 5 dropbacks with the starting offense, but recorded 3 carries on those plays. Remember, Watson's 6 carries per game to close the year with Cleveland finished 8th among all quarterbacks, and his 14.3 points per game as the QB25 in fantasy was his first time averaging less than 20. We think Watson's going to bounce back in a big way. And if he's going to be running the ball like this, he has genuine top 5 upside. Sam Howell also continued to show that he's a rushing quarterback. Dating back to last preseason, Howell has now recorded 19 carries on 137 dropbacks, a 13.8% scramble rate. Quarterback ADP the past few years has actually corrected itself, since rushing quarterbacks are being drafted correctly as a cheat code. But Howell is still in the 18th round on Sleeper and Yahoo drafts. He's slipping through the cracks as a genuine starter for 2 quarterback and superflex leagues. Kenneth Gainwell didn't play a single snap with Philadelphia's offense, but I don't think that means we should be higher on him. Trey Sermon played 29 snaps, Rashad Penny 27, Kennedy Brooks 13, and DeAndre Swift 6. The entire point we should be drafting Gainwell is because he's going in the 14th round, as opposed to DeAndre Swift, who's being drafted in the 7th. And we know this Eagles backfield is going to be a committee. We're just playing the game of fantasy football and buying the dip, rather than paying a premium for Swift. I still want to draft Gainwell from the 14th round on in every league. Last but not least, Jake Ferguson. Late round tight end is only ever fun until you're forced to start a late round tight end in week 1. But Jake Ferguson deserves to be in that pool of players. Including his 3 targets on Saturday from Cooper Rush, Ferguson has now been targeted on 22.8% of his routes dating back to last year. That would have ranked 7th among all tight ends last season. And with third rounder Luke Schoonmaker suffering a setback with his foot injury in camp and just now catching up to the playbook, we think Ferguson is going to be Dallas's starting tight end from Dak Prescott as early as week 1. That makes him a late round option, especially in tight end premium leagues. You can find all this and more at 444.com/plans. Use the promo code YouTube for 25% off. And remember, be a little bit kinder than what's required.